In today's video, we are going to talk about Windows 365 Cloud PC Explained, what it is, how it works, and how to set it up. Myself, Mohammed Zubair, and this channel is all about showing you how to become a highly paid IT pro really fast. So without any further ado, let's get started. Well, Windows 365 is your cloud PC that works just like any PC that you have in your office or home. To understand it in a better way, let's take a scenario. Let's say you go to market, you buy a system with some pretty good hardware resources that are sufficient enough to do some heavy processing. Let's say you use some heavy games or software on your device and the hardware resources you bought are sufficient. But when you leave the market, you do not take the system with you. You just take login credentials with you and you just come back home. Now, you have an average PC, laptop or some older machine available at home. You just need to log in into Windows 365 Admin Center and you can start using your PC that you have bought from the market on your device that is available at your home. Windows 365 works in the same manner. We buy resources online and then we can access that PC with selected resources from any device. Now question comes into mind, why do we need to buy online PC? Well, as I had an average machine at my home and that was not good enough for my gaming or some other heavy duty work, and now with the help of Windows 365, I can use that powerful PC from my average PC. Let's say I have 2 GB of RAM and 120 GB of storage into my laptop, but the PC that I have bought online possesses 16 GB of RAM and 512 GB of SSD. Not only that, I can also bought some of the heavy processors if I need. Now, with the help of my laptop that I have with minimal resources, I can access that resources online. Now, one more question needs to be answered here, and that is, why should not I buy a laptop with enough resources and carry it with me anywhere? And why should I buy a cloud PC? Well, let's say you want to increase the hardware resources of your laptop. For that, you have to go to market. But in case of Windows 365, you can simply go to admin center of it and increase the hardware resources for you. And no need to go to market and no compulsion of having heavy system at your hand to access the heavy PC that you have just bought from Windows 365. There is one more benefit with having Windows 365, and that is, let's say you have average internet connection at home, but for your requirement, you need a very powerful internet connection to download some file or for streaming purpose. With Windows 365, you get up to 10 gigabytes of internet speed. So how quick is that? You do not need to have heavy internet connection at your device or at your home. You just need an internet connection that is sufficient enough to log you on your cloud PC. And everything else will be done on its own in terms of the internet needs. One other major benefit of having Windows 365 is, as our system will be on Microsoft Cloud, all the updates related to Windows and all the security concerns will be taken care of by the Microsoft itself. Now let's talk about some of the drawbacks of Windows 365. Well, just like companies had to get used to the idea of paying for a software subscription rather than just purchasing it one time, Windows 365 is a similar case. Instead of buying a computer and not having that cost come around again for 3 to 5 years, because we optimize our system that are optimal enough for next 5 years or 3 years, now we need to pay monthly subscription fee for our Windows 365. So that might be a concern for a lot of people. And let's say I have a touch system or I use pen for different drawings. And we have no idea that how that cloud PC is gonna react to that. And what if there is latency or lag in the service? What will happen then? So these are some of the potential drawbacks that we have to consider before going for Windows 365, but I'm sure with the passage of time, we'll see improvement in all these aspects. Now I'll show you that how you can set up your Windows 365 or your cloud PC. Well, just log in into Microsoft 365 Admin Center, and if you do not have your account, you have to create it. After that, here we have some of the sections on the left side. This is the home. Here we have some of the information about user management, billing, training and guides, and some other things. After that, we have user section. If you just click on it, here we will have active users, contacts, guest user, and those users that you have deleted. If I click on active users, here I have two of the users available at this moment. And then we have teams and groups. In teams and groups, we'll have active teams and groups, deleted groups, and shared mailboxes. Well, obviously, as we have different users, we can create different teams and groups based on those users. After that, we have billing section. From here, you will have all the information and all the access to all the licenses and all the services that you have bought. For example, if I click on purchase services, here I'll have all the services that I can buy. Then I have my your products. In that, I'll have those products that I have bought. Then same goes for licenses. Then we have bill and payments. And here we have payment methods. Well, if you just click on this one, this is my payment method. And in case if I want to remove this payment method, I can just click on this three-dot menu button, or I can just check this checkbox. And from here, I can click on this delete button. But before deleting this one, we have to add another payment method so that we can keep using our Windows 365. If I go to my your products, these are my products that I had bought earlier. And after using it, I have deleted all of these. In case if you want to delete any of your product, just click its checkbox. You will get the option to delete that product, or you can also do that by clicking on these three-dot menu button. So that was all about it, and now let's move ahead and let's buy a subscription for our Windows 365. For that purpose, we have to go to our billing section and then click on purchase services. From here, as we want cloud PC, so we'll go with Windows 365. Just click on it, and from here, just click on details. Because here we have some of the options. For example, we have Windows 365 Business, Windows 365 Business with Windows Hybrid Benefit. I'll not go into that. And we also have Windows 365 Enterprise. And here we have the amount that will get charged per license. I'll go with Windows 365 Business. So I'll just click on details. Now, from here, we have to select a plan. And according to that plan, we'll get charged. For example, I want to buy 4 GB of RAM and 64 GB of storage. And for that, I'll get charged $32 per license per month. And with that, I'll get 2 processors. In case if you want to get more resources, you can do so. For example, here at the bottom, I have 8 processors, 32 GB of RAM and 512 GB of storage. And for that, I'll get charged $162 per license per month. I'll go with the first option, in which I'll get 1 processor, 2 GB of RAM and 64 GB of storage space. So I'll just go up and I'll select my plan, and here it is. So I will just click on this first one, and after that we have a button that says buy. So I'll just click on it. Here it is loading everything and it is processing. It will take a little bit of time. So from here, we have the summary of everything that we have done and we have bought. And in case if you want to increase the number of licenses with the same specification, you can do so by just clicking on this arrow button. Here you can see I am adding more and more licenses. I'll go with the one only, and after that, just click on this place order button, and our order will get placed and we'll be able to use our cloud PC. Here we are all set, and now we need to assign that license to a particular user. For that purpose, we have to go back to our admin. So either you can click on this button, or you can go to its menu, and from here you can click on this admin. I'll just click on this go to admin home button, and from here now we need to go to our users. In here, go to your active users. It will show us all the users that are active. Now from here, select the user to whom you want to assign that cloud PC that you have just bought. I want to assign this to this person, which is Hafiz Saif. So I will just click on this one and it will open the user and its information and all the things that are assigned to him. So this is the account of that user. Here will be the devices that are assigned to him. Then in here that says licenses and apps, just click on this section and from here click on Windows 365 business, 1 CPU, 2 GB of RAM, 64 GB of storage. This is another one that I had bought earlier, but this is the one that we just bought. So I will just click on this one. After that, just click on save changes. And this PC will be assigned to this particular user. So I'll just click on save changes. Now our changes have been saved. I need to just close this one. Now we need to log in into our windows365.microsoft.com. So I will just do that, hit enter. And here we have our PC that we had just bought and it is getting set up. As you can see, here we have all those resources that we had bought as 1 CPU, 2 GB of RAM, 64 GB of storage. It will take a little bit of time, so you have to be patient. So our cloud PC is up and ready. Now we can use it. If you click on this gear icon, from here we can restart it, we can reset it, we can restore it, we can rename, and in case if you get into any problem, you can troubleshoot it. And if you want to know some of the system information, you have to just click on this one. Right now, I'll just rename my system. I will name it as Skills Build and I will just click on rename. And now our system will have a new name as Skills Build. Now we are ready to go. For that purpose, you just need to click on this button that says open in browser. So I will just click on this one. Other than that, there is one thing that I want to discuss, and that is you can also download the remote desktop. It will download an application for you and you can access your cloud PC directly from the device or from the application that you have downloaded, and it will work as your remote desktop. So if I go into my this tab, in here it is asking for some of the permissions. I want to access printer, microphone and clipboard. That is why I'll go with all these options. And if you want to go with some advanced settings, just click on this one. And from here, you can enable alternative keyboard layout. I'll not go into that. I'll just click on connect. It will set up our connection and it will open a remote port for us. And in here, we are done with the port. Now we need to enter the password for this user. So I will just enter its password. After that, click on sign in. And now it will establish our connection. So now it is preparing our windows to use, and from here if you want to have full window preview, just click on this double headed arrow and now we have preview on the whole window. In case if you want to collapse your toolbar, you can do so as well. So we are done with everything and our PC is ready to use. Here you can see it is just responding as any other desktop PC that you might see. Other than that, we have our Microsoft Edge here, we have File Explorer, we have store here, and if I click on my start button, here I have all those applications that I might get into any PC that I'll use physically. Now I'll go to the settings of my this PC. So I'll just click on that one and from here I'll go to my accounts. So this is the user at the moment and he's administrator. Well, all the Windows 365 business users have local administrator privileges on their cloud PCs. So they also have the permissions that require to install any applications they need or they require. And as we can see that this user is the administrator of this cloud PC, and obviously this user will be able to use this one and he can connect different devices with it as well. And now I'll go to the update section of my cloud PC. Here it is. I will just click on this one. So as I have mentioned earlier, all the updates and all the security things will be managed by Microsoft itself, and I do not have to worry about anything. And in case if you want to see what are the updates and what are their configuration, you can do so by just clicking on it. And if at the top you see it says some settings are managed by your organization, so it means you do not have to worry about anything. I'll just open my File Explorer and let's see what do we have here. So I'll go to my this PC And in here, I have my C drive. And if you remember, when we bought the cloud PC, we opted for 64 gigabytes of storage. And here you can see we have same. Now I will right click on my this PC and I'll go to its properties. And here we have 2 gigabytes of RAM, exactly the same we bought. Then we have the system information, like you have device ID, product ID, and in case of operating system, we are using Windows 10 Enterprise by default in it. Well, if you go with 2 CPUs, mean 2 processors, 4 gigabytes of RAM, and even 64 gigabytes of storage, you will get Windows 11 by default into your cloud PC. But as we are going with 2 gigabytes of RAM and 64 gigabytes of storage, that is why we are getting Windows 10 in our cloud PC. And that brings us to the end of today's video. I hope now that now you have better idea and now you understand that what Windows 365 and cloud PC is, how it works, and how you can set it up as per your liking and as per your needs. If that is the case, please leave a like, subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon. We'll get back to you in the next video. Till then, take care.